One more question we'll discuss.
Sir, is there any particular reason as to why both of them are same?
Stability of carbonyl in the first one, basic medium, and here it is alkene. So we'll just try to get more stable alkene in basic medium and more stable carbonyl in basic medium.
Sir, so, but there's no rule like we can look at the initial compound and save the.
No, 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 it's not. We just have to, if medium is basic, write down the carbonyl in that form. Acidic, write down the alkene and compare the stability. Okay? This one, tell me. OH minus and H plus. OH minus, write down the carbonyl that forms, write down the alkene here and compare this to it. We'll get here triad and space, right?
So both are same, yeah. This time also.
Triad and space, both major products are same. Major products same in both the cases. So two carbonyl that we get here is double bond O. We'll get a carbonyl here, and we'll get a carbonyl here, right? Basic mediums, we write down the carbonyl. Two, this one is triad, and this one is space. Which negative charge is more stable? Why?
Conjugation.
Large conjugation. Okay? This is in conjugation till this oxygen, and here we have lesser conjugation, right? This is more stable. It means this gives you what? Major product. So major product will write according to the more stable carbon ion. This comes over here. This is the product we get, right? And here the minor will be in this one is the cross conjugation, extended conjugation. This is the major product. Yeah, in acidic medium we'll write down the alkene directly. So we'll get a double bond here and double bond here, right? So two different alkene that we get here is double bond OH, double bond plus, extended conjugation here, alkene is more stable, this is the major product. You see in this also, two different medium, we are getting same major product, right? So we cannot generalize.
So if we had to count the alpha hydrogen, we count them for both the double bonds?
No, we count for this one only because it's aspirant hybridized. Three.
Wait, sir, but what if there was like one more CH3 group on the last one?
That is six.
Yeah. Then you count it.
Both.
So the rule is that resonance is
key. Right. Resonance, aromaticity, dominance over resonance. Balancing resonance to a certain extent dominates over aromaticity. Got it, okay? So we cannot generalize that the major product in acidic medium becomes minor in basic. Okay, we cannot generalize that.
Is it same because there's a space and a triad?
No, it's just because this carbonyl is more stable than this.
So because even in the last one there's a space in triad, and the one, 2 months before that where it was opposite, it was only two space, only two triad.
See, you can say that, but I haven't seen this anywhere. Like, you cannot generalize that. So maybe you get one example here and there where the thing is not going through, right? That's why we do that. Okay. Next we'll start stereoisomerism. Structure we have done. Stereoisomerism. Stereoisomerism. This will take 2 hours. Geometrical isomerism. Geometrical, we have to discuss then optical and then conformational isomers. Okay? No, we'll discuss the geometrical. right onto this. These are the isomers. These are the isomers which has the same molecular and structural formula. Geometrical isomers, these are the isomers which has the same molecular or structural formula. Molecular and structural formula. But the arrangement of atoms or groups, but the arrangement of atoms or groups in space is different. In space is different due to the restricted rotation, due to the restricted rotation across carbon-carbon double bond, across carbon-carbon double bond, or any ring structure. Triple bond not possible. Across carbon-carbon double bond. Across carbon-carbon double bond or ring structure. Okay? So, you see, the rotation is restricted across the carbon-carbon double bond. What does it mean? Suppose, what is the name of this compound? What is the name of this compound? Just H. What is the name of this compound? That's not the butuin. These two are different compounds. Or same compound? Same or different?
The difference, sir.
Then why are you saying the same name? Butene, 2-butene.
No, the compound is same, but the
same. Sir, it's geometric isomerism.
Okay, if I write down this example, then. What about these two?
So they
Okay, see this is structure. These two structures are same structure. Equivalent structure, these two.
Is trans Z or E?
What Z? What are you talking about?
Then Sengish, they said trans and cis, they said Z and E.
It can be anything. E can be cis also and trans also. Z can be cis also. So E and Z has nothing to do with cis and trans. Like, as any E has the word cis over
and
trans.
What is E in word? This would be Z.
Sir, will you explain cis and trans?
I'll explain. Let me explain. No, you're not. Okay, stop talking. See, first of all, these two compounds, right, these two compounds are different compounds. Why different compound? Because the position of these two, this methyl group and this methyl group here, and this methyl group here is different. Okay? This distance, suppose this distance is L1, right? But this distance is not L1, it is different from the distance over here, it is L2. And it is observed that this distance, L2, is more than L1. Okay? Because both are at opposite end, right? Like here, 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 right? So this distance is more. So obviously, when the distance is more, the repulsion will be less, right? Two bulky group are far apart, so repulsion will be less comparatively here, and hence we can say this compound is relatively more stable than this. Okay? So when stability is different, obviously the two compounds are also different compounds. Same compound, no other stability will be same, okay? Right? If the two compounds are same, their stability physical properties, chemical properties, everything will be same, right? Molecular formula is same for this one, right? But their stability is different, hence these two compounds are what? These two compounds are different compounds. And it is, they are known as geometrical isomers of each other. They are GI, geometrical isomers of each other, because same molecular formula, but the arrangement of atoms or groups across carbon-carbon double bond is different, right? Here they are at opposite end, same side of the carbon-carbon double bond. So arrangement is different, different compounds, geometrical isomers. Here what happens, we do not have double bond here. So we can rotate the carbon-carbon bond this way. Rotation is not hindered. So when I say hindered rotation across carbon-carbon double bond, it means what? Suppose this carbon, we have carbon-carbon double bond, right? Now when the pi bond is there, how this pi bond forms? Bilateral overlapping of the two orbital. This is pi bond, right? This is pi bond, right? Now when you try to rotate this, suppose this carbon is fixed and this carbon you try to rotate. If you rotate this carbon in this way, you'll get this molecule, right? So if you want to rotate one of the carbon atom, you have to rotate this way, right? So that pi bond you have to break, which is not possible. Bond you cannot break, right? That's why we say we have hindered rotation across carbon-carbon double bond. But this rotation is not hindered here because this is only carbon-carbon single bond. You can rotate this, you'll get the other molecule, right? So these two are same molecule, butane, but these two are different molecules.
So triple bond
also won't move there. Triple bond move, but that won't show isomerism because it's linear. Aisa hi hai. So kya rotate rakha jana chahte ho?
Both are hydrogen.
Yes, so it's like a linear molecule, right? Aisa hi kuch hai. Kya karo rotate rakha? The entire molecule will rotate, right? So there's no point of talking this alkyne if you're discussing this. So these two compounds are different compounds because of the hindered rotation across carbon-carbon double bond. Even with ring also it is possible, right? So this kind of compound we call it as what? Geometrical isomers of each other. Geometrical isomers of each other. Now in this we have two, three different representation. Because when you do the IUPAC nomenclature of this, you'll say bute-2-ene. This one is also bute-2-ene, right? So if I ask you to draw the structure of bute-2-ene, some of you will draw this one and some of you will draw this. And since both the compounds are different compounds, so we are not very sure that which structure we have to draw with bute-2-ene, if only I say, right? So to specify this, whether we are talking about this molecule or this molecule, we have given a specific term over here. And that term is cis or trans, syn, anti, E or C. Right? Three different types of, you know, representation we have. We can talk about cis and trans. We can talk about E and Z. Or we can talk about syn and anti. Right, suppose for this example, this is cis isomer and this one is trans isomer. How do we say it is cis and trans? I'll come to that. But suppose if I tell you, draw the structure of cis-2-butene, it means both CH3 must be on the same side of double bond, so you have to draw this structure. Trans-2-butene is opposite side, right? That is the significance of these terms, okay? So cis and trans isomer, we define only when the double bonded carbon atom contains identical group on it. The CH3 and yahan bhi CH3, H hai yahan bhi H. So we can define the cis and trans with respect to one of the identical group present on the double bonded carbon atom. And what is cis? When the identical group present on the same side of double bond, carbon-carbon double bond, then the compound is said to be cis isomer of that. When the identical group, whether it is CH3 or H, are on the opposite side of the carbon-carbon double bond, it is trans isomer of each other. Is it clear? Right? Syn and anti or EZ we use for more substituted alkene. This is, for example, suppose isko main agar CN yahan pe likh deta hu. Okay? So this one is more substituted than the previous one where we have H hydrogen present here. So this we can also define as cis and trans, and we can also define as E and Z. Okay? This molecule is said to be cis with respect to what? CH3. Right? It can be E or Z also. And how do we find out E and Z? For that we have to assign the priority on the group. We'll discuss that one by one.
So won't its name change?
Huh? Name will be different, but whether it is cis or trans, it is cis with respect to CS3. ENZ also we can define because it is more substituted. Syn and NT we define when the molecule has this kind of bond, N double bond N or C double bond N. This can also show geometrical isomers because we have double bonded hindered rotation. Okay, so syn and NT is mainly defined for nitrogen containing compound. Okay, ENZ is defined for more substituted alkene. Like for example, if I write down this C double bond C and both the carbon atom contains halogen group, Br and I. So in this we cannot define cis and trans because identical group to hai nahi wapne. Both carbon atom does not contain same group. All the four groups are what? Different. So in this case we'll define what? We'll define ENZ. Right? If any of the two groups are same, suppose main yahan Br likh deta hu. So with respect to bromine it is cis. Right, but we can also call it as E or Z isomer.
We choose what to call this, and the other one will be the other letter.
Preferably, we'll write this as E and Z.
And Z.
E or Z, not Z. Means whatever it comes. If it comes E, then E. Z, then Z, and then Z. Right.
So we like for this, we like all this E or Z.
We'll see how to do that. We have to understand first the priority order, and then we have a rule for that to assign E and Z isomer.
So over here, instead of having two hydrogens and a methyl group, instead of I had like methyl hydrogen and chlorine, and over there methyl chlorine hydrogen.
This is the same molecule.
Ion.
Like no matter how I.
No, वहाँ पे double bond है ही नहीं. There's no double bond. यहाँ पे you can talk. CH3, chlorine and this.
No, but if I had like three things attached to it, but in different order, like one was.
उससे कुछ because carbon is sp3. So four corners of tetrahedral geometry is identical position. So whatever, you know, if you place this CH3 here, H here, and here chlorine, that won't make any difference. Because sp3 hybridization, tetrahedral geometry, so all the four atoms or groups represent the corner of the tetrahedron. And all four positions are what? Equivalent position. Okay, so that relative things will be same. Understood this thing? These three things we define here. Okay, now we'll see some examples here. Okay, you see this structure C double bond C, COOH, COOH, hydrogen and hydrogen. And the other molecule C double bond C, COOH, COOH, hydrogen and hydrogen. This compound, the name of this compound is malic acid, M-A-L-E-I-C. This is malic acid and this is fumaric acid. This name you must remember.
So for gamma, when you give us common names and ask us.
I forgot what question I have given. I don't remember. One or two questions will be there for nomenclature.
What was that name? No, but like common name. I mean, nomenclature is only two questions.
Huh. How much is
at least 10.
No. Okay, see the relation between this malic acid and fumaric acid is what? They are geometrical isomers of it. So this question they have asked once. The relation between malic and fumaric acid are, they are geometrical isomers of each other. This one is cis. Can you tell me the name of this compound?
Bute-1,4-dioic acid.
Bute 1?
No.
So 1,4 is understood because we have to start numbering.
So I just
use
the
diionic
acid.
Dioic acid. Okay.
So 1,4 dioic.
So we can also put the numbers in.
Like the 1,4 by Sukhi Mako. 1,4 dioic acid. But if you write dioic acid, that is also fine. Because we are bound to give first position to this carbon atom. So 1 and 4 it is. Okay? Now, if it is both COOH group present on the same side, right, it is cis form of this. Cis but 2-ene-1,4 dipoic acid. This one is what? Trans. Trans but 2-ene-1,4
dipoic acid. Cis and but?
Not required. We write actually this way.
Okay.
Okay. So this you must remember, malic acid is the cis form of but 2-ene-1,4 dipoic acid, and fumaric acid is the trans form of this, right? The relation between malic acid and fumaric acid, that they are geometrical isomers of each other. Okay?
So can you give us an example with three things so that we know when not to take the...
You have done so much of question on non-infection, no?
Yeah.
I have done this thing in the exam, in the class also. So it is 1, 2, 3, propane, 1,2,3, tricarboxylic acid.
Wait, so is,
carbon-containing functional group directly attached to the unbranched alkane.